instructor foot, they're only allowed to run for 7 minutes. That's the maximum amount of time they're able to run for. And then at the end of that, it's all finished. Now, guys, it's one of those things. Drama, VCE drama and VCE theatre studies is not for the faint-hearted, because you get 7 minutes and it's worth 35% of your final assessment score for the subject. So you get it right, it's fantastic. And the way you get it right, Tane, is by doing lots of what?
Practice.
Correct.
Until attack.
That's the only way that you get it right, which is what they've been doing lots of. So today you guys are the audience that will be viewing them for the last formal time before they present it, which is on Monday down in Warrnambool, to assess us down there. Now you need to say something?
Oh, just going to explain the structure.
Okay, yep.
So when they put together this solo, it's not, someone else hasn't written it, so they don't have any words for it to learn. They have to actually create it from scratch. So that's why it's a bit hard for, unless you know what the story's about, it's a bit hard to understand. So you guys are just here to appreciate the her acting skills. But I'm just going to explain to you what they have to include. So I assume we're going in running order, or is Katie going last?
Katie goes last.
So we're starting with you, Tane. So Tane's character is called Narcissus. A narcissist is a person who loves only themselves, is infatuated with themselves. So Narcissus, the person, or the myth, was an ancient Greek myth of a person who fell in love with his, couldn't love anyone except himself, fell in love with his own reflection in a pond, and in doing so, fell into the pond and drowned and became a daffodil. So what Tane has to show is this: blaming Narcissus for human self-obsession and vanity, which has caused their addiction to technology and social media, Zeus banishes Narcissus back to Earth to set things right. Shocked at what he discovers, Narcissus attempts to bring about a change in order to stop humans from suffering a fate similar to his own. Narcissus must do this by recreating moments from his own story that act as a warning to humankind, offering two or more creative solutions on how humans can overcome their self-obsession, creating a parallel to one or more famous people who could be considered narcissists. He has to show aspects of Greek theatre, and his dramatic element is...
My dramatic element is conflict, and my convention is fatal flaw.
So he has to show both of those things as well. So he has to be able to show all of those things. So you should see some other narcissists. You should see something about social media. You should see something about people being obsessed by social media. You should see a fatal flaw, and you should see some conflict.
Inside of all that too, you can see there's a space marked out on the floor. He may not step out of the space if he steps out of the space at any time they stop assessing. So it's
just
pretty
like gymnastic.
It's really, really rigid.
Just like gymnastics.
Just like gymnastics.
It's a 5 by 5 meter space, and that's what he's got to perform. And so it is pretty demanding.
When they go to do their performance, there will just be three other people in the room there, the three assessors who don't actually speak to them, so they perform to an empty space.
Which is actually much more stressful than this, because I've got to perform to like three periodized people.
Scary, Rocky. Just saying.
Huh?
I'm judging you, so.
Oh, thank you.
Just put you in the mode.
Right, when you're ready.
My performance will begin after the pits.
I'm looking at the man in the mirror. Thy smiles return my own. I am tortured by a desire before unknown. O marvellous boy, I loved you in vain. Farewell, farewell, farewell.
Hello! Zeus, is that you?
Of course it is I! Who else would face Hyme the dead?
Sure, but you're holding the phone wrong. You're not in shot.
Here There's trouble on Earth, and it's your fault.
My fault? I've been wandering as lonely as a daffodil in the hereafter for millennia. How could it be my fault?
Hear me, young Narcissus. To Earth's side you must go. Social media be thy foe. To save the humans from the void, you must defeat the android. Hey, Siri. Call him an Uber. Hop in, Narcissus! We gotta get back to the future!
Come with me, and you'll be in a world of pure imagination.
Good morning, everybody. Based on the health advice, I just have to stress, we're infectious in the community. Death is horrible, but we have to keep in mind there are 8 million people with no choice on how they spend their free time. Welcome to the internet, have a look around. Post an inspiration post, go and see who likes it most. Dead eyes on a selfie, take a scroll down to another faker. I can be violet sky. Can I interest you in everything all of the time? I'm too sexy for your love, too sexy for your space. My space. Top friends. Tom, Zeus, Echo.
Who?
Hera. No. Nemesis, definitely not. Arminius. No, but I'll send you a gift. 250 million ought to do it. If he should love, deny him what he loves.
I officially resign as New South Wales Premier.
Update!
Zeus, you must take some of the blame for this. If you'd stayed off Tinder, none of this would have happened. Hera cursed Echo, and now she just retweets everything I say. In revenge, Nemesis drags me and the humans back to our own reflection. And now they're trapped. All they hear are their own thoughts repeated back to them in... I have to go back and change the algorithm.
Navigating to Silicon Valley.
We have to remove the likes mark. If we remove them, then the humans will stop obsessing over them. We have to change the algorithm. A post without a like. Well, the result would be a decline in user posts and a continued move into the real world.
We'll begin with some spin, traveling in a world of my creation. Blue, I can be violet sky. I can be orange, I can be blonde. I will tweet anything I like. China virus, nothing to worry about. Fake news.
Who's there? Come out!
There. Out.
Echo, look, I'm just not that into you. And you have to stop retweeting every mover. Make America great again. JNCs, big right.
I am still the President of the United States.
I am sorry to inform that at real Donald Trump, your account's been suspended permanently. due to risk of further incitement of violence. If you want to make the world a better place, take a look at yourself and then make a change your ways, humans. Live life, not a reflection of it. Realize, don't idealize. Let's put TikTok back in the clock. Stop tweeting and start talking. Let's make heaven and earth truly great again. Life is not a highlight reel. Take off thy masks. Be thyselves. Brown, I can be blue, I can be violet sky. You can be purple, you can be hurtful, you can be anything you like.
Echo was rejected by Narcissus, and so she lost her voice. Amy's structure is an historical structure. Mr. Wells, you will enjoy this one. It's the life and times of Ida B. Wells. Ida B. Wells was a civil rights activist a long time back, an African American woman who fought for the rights of African Americans. So this one's called The Life and Times of Ida B. Wells. In 2021, a passionate Ida B. Wells appears before the Vice President of the United States of America after a particularly bad day at the White House. So she's talking to Kamala Harris. Ida states emphatically that past policies for equality have not worked, and she encourages the Vice President to create a new vision for the future. She does this by recreating moments from her career that demonstrate the inequality and racism she's seen and or experienced, showing key moments in the fight for equality in the history of the US from 1931 to the present day, and creating a parallel to one or more people who have campaigned for social or political change. The style of theatre that Amy has to present is eclectic, which means a mixture of everything. And what's your element?
My dramatic element is tension, and my convention is pathos.
Cool. So you should feel sad at some times.
Gathered here tonight, a nation in mourning, to pay tribute to the lives we have lost to COVID-19. Black, angry, are you gonna take away our guns? Leftist puppets, take away our freedom! Kamala, I paved the way for you. The way to right wrongs is to turn the light of truth upon them. Move out of the white, Carman. No. The only tired I was tired of giving in. Come on. glass ceiling is still in place, and there are significant failings within the power structures of our institution.
In the case of Harvey Weinstein, I find the accused guilty of all charges. First, lynching is color line murder. Crime and requires a national remedy. Innocent victims are killed in these acts. If we refocus our efforts on education, we'll make a big impact. White woman, women, African Americans, fight. Do you take this woman to be your lawfully wedded wife? Do they dismember them afterwards and pass around the body. Viola Wells, who tells your story? Who'll tell my story? We will not be turned around or interrupted by intimidation, because we know that our inaction and our inertia will be the inheritance of the next generation. Today to witness Joe Biden establish Juneteenth as a national holiday. We have come far and we have far to go. A day for us to reaffirm and rededicate ourselves to action. She told my story.
before, practice makes perfect when it comes to performing something with that much precision. How well did she interact with that soundtrack? Pretty hard to make sure that you do exactly the right motion when the glass breaks, etc. So, our next performer is Zoe, and her structure is Queen Cleopatra of Egypt. So it's called The Life and Times of Cleopatra the Seventh. She needs to create a solo performance based on the person, Queen Cleopatra of Egypt. On the eve of the Battle of Actium, Cleopatra is making an offering to the goddess Isis, appealing for support in order to defeat Octavian and strengthen her own power. Afraid that Isis will ignore her appeal, the calculating Cleopatra demonstrates to Isis the benefits of her continued reign. Cleopatra does this by recreating key moments in her life as queen, including her alignment with Isis, showing how she manipulated various men in her life in order to gain and maintain her power, and creating an example of another real or fictional femme fatale. Femme fatale is a female person who tries to gain power by attracting men. She also has to show aspects of Greek theatre, and I think she's using Photophore as well, and contrast. And mask, because masks are also an aspect of Greek theatre. And Zoe's is contrast, so we're looking for a switch up between ancient and modern.
Hear me, O Isis. O hear me and save. For the battle of Actium is to come. Hear me, O Isis. Oh, hear me and save me! I can't do this. I am a woman. A woman in politics. Since 31 BC. I'm she, who they call the goddess of women. This is not what I meant by an arranged marriage. Intelligence is the ultimate justice more powerful than silver and gold. Syrians, come on to me. Our wealth become your wealth. Our power, your power. Right. Give me my robe, put on my crown, for the juice of Egypt's grape shall moist this lip. You never kill the addict, only those that surround him. Forever and always, we will be just like children. I'm not that innocent. It's your protest. I did not send you. If he seems sad, say I am dancing.
Two of her brothers. So that little bit where Zoe was doing the looking in disgust at whoever she was about to marry was because she was heading down the aisle and realized it was Ptolemy 13 or Ptolemy 14. And then she did it again. So it happened a couple of times. Oops, she did it again. Yeah.
I know. I just don't want to.
The last solo is Caitlin's. Caitlin is playing a character called the Princess, which I think when they wrote this structure was initially designed to be kind of a frivolous and happy character, but Katie's taken it. If you saw Katie's Witch last year, you know that she doesn't do frivolous and happy lightly. So she's taken a bit of a darker turn on the princess, and she's contrasting her princess with the way that women are generally treated in society. So. The structure is about a solo performance based on the character of the princess, in this case Aurora, fed up with life of waiting for her happily ever after ending and keen to create her own destiny, the princess rallies her fellow fairy tale characters. Chastising her less than impressed colleagues, she calls on them to break free from traditional stereotypes and to pave the way for a new generation of fairy tale characters. She does this by highlighting one or more outdated messages in her own story, as well as in other well-known fairy tales, by creating examples of how a traditional fairy tale could be altered to have a more inclusive or diverse message, and showing examples of two or more real-life women who went against tradition and created their own destiny. And your convention and dramatic element are?
My convention is satire, and my dramatic element is conflict.
Interesting in terms of satire, Carl here just asked, am I the only one who thinks she looks like Sleeping Beauty?
Ah,
yes.
That's good. Well done, Kyle.
Yes.
That's exactly who she's supposed to look like.
That's exactly who she is. So what do you say first? We'll begin talk, blah, 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 after.
I will begin my performance after the piece.
The next thing I knew, I was in labor. I know it's too. What's yours is also mine. You will be mine, mine, mine. Yours, yours. Your blemishes. Look natural. Be chaste. Be sexy. Go on a diet. Why don't you just eat? L'Oreal, because you're worth it. I'm not a puppet. I'm a real man. Did you see what she was wearing? Stop overreacting. Don't be a girl.
Built by men for men to protect men. The justice system is notoriously stacked against victims of sexual crimes. All the better to eat you with, he said. Yeah, it's probably my fault. I understand. Take ownership of your story. Free yourself. Together we can bring about real, meaningful reform to ensure the next generation of women are safer and more equitable. Future fairy tale characters will thank us. Stop living your life by the book. Snow White. There are seven of them. Surely one of them can do the laundry. Ariel. Don't lose your voice. Use your voice, hen. Cinderella. If the shoe fits. Why did it fall off? Stop! I don't want to marry him. I want to marry her. Oh,
3. The only thing you should be chasing is your dream.
I will not be lectured about sexism and misogyny by this man. I will not. If he wants to know what sexism and misogyny look like in modern Australia, he needs a mirror. 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 Mirror.
These are the fairest of them all. Was the end of a fairy tale. There were three of us in marriage. I suppose it was a bit crowded.
Mine.
No, I'm the people's princess. What do you mean, whatever love is, Charles?
Any more?
Why is a man in a room full of women ecstatic when a woman in a room full of men is terrified? Be ruthless in the defense of boundaries you set for yourself. Speak up, share your truth. Challenge the stereotypes. Reject the patriarchy. Fairy tale sisters, unite! We can make you fit. Not guilty! Not guilty! Not guilty! Sleeping corpses are not guilty.
The audience with any questions for them. You can actually ask those questions now if you wanted to while they're still kind of in character. It's one of those journeys that they've all been on over the last term. And as can Kerry and a number of the others attest to the fact that there's been a lot of blood, sweat, and yes, a lot of tears to get them.
That's just mine.
To get them this far. It's a labour of love. And As an outcome at BC level, for it to be worth 30, like I said to you guys before, BC drama is definitely not for the faint-hearted. Because as you saw with these four today, you have to commit, you've got to be 100% in, you can't half do any of these characters, which is what makes them absolute consummate performers. So, congratulations.
Who had a favourite bit that they could identify?
Come on.
Oh, it's all bad.
It's all bad.
Horrible. Julia Gillard loved it.
Yeah. Oh, Julia Gillard?
Yeah.
There's so many shades of crazy in these people. When you see them getting around in the school, you don't necessarily see that, but they are bonkers.
Julia Gillard.
Oh, Lady Diana. Fine.
I think it was very intense, the I Can't Breathe. Very captivating.
So one of the things they look for in all of the solos is, and you would have seen that, it's a real pivotal, a really important moment. They must have parallels to contemporary society, which is why we see Donald Trump. That's why we see I Can't Breathe. That's why we're seeing, you know, Julia Gillard. They make these appearances because that's part of the character that they're doing.
Because
so satire
history,
character.
History is just a repetition of itself, really.
Yeah,
so
and all still relevant.
Incidents happen in every age that can be connected.
Right, you guys scout. I'm going to get some photos of these guys.
Jeffrey, you head back.